Good afternoon, my name is Commander Black Dragon at your service, and today's date is the 13th of the 9th 2015, and it's about 13 past 12 in the evening. Now, this is my latest build on the Python. I think I might stick to this one. It's pretty much an all-rounder. So we'll go quickly into what we have here, because I'll go hunt down some pirates and kill them to test the firing grip. So first of all, what we have here, when it comes up, is we're going to use two cannons on top. They're gimbal cannons. Then I've got two burst lasers underneath and another burst laser. So we've got one F3 burst laser underneath and then two F2 burst lasers. We have a chef cannon, heat sink launcher and two shield boosters. The internals, we've got mirrored armor, A1 power plant, A thrusters, A frameshift drive, D life support, so we can increase the latent power, latent jump, and also the less power we're using. Power distributor is A, sensors at D, fuel tanks the same, cargo racks are the same, A6 shield jump. Now this is where I did change it. I put an A4 instead of an A5. I could put an A5 there as well, but I might have a look into that. Put one A5 and one A4. I'll see for how they work. But basically, I've got one A4 there. Fuel skill is A5, and of course an A4 there. Now I could put an A5 there because it'll give me exactly the same amount of charge, but the power consumption of it would be a lot different. I'd have to change. I have a look at things. Probably wouldn't change much at all. I actually wouldn't change any of the settings. Detailed surface scanner, advanced discovery spanner, and a standard docking computer. As I said before, this is an all-round Python. With the lasers, I should be able to take out small to medium targets, and with the big cannons, I should be able to help take out big targets. There's my ranking at the moment: Dangerous 44, Elite 100, and Surveyor 99. Modules, pretty much. You want to keep it in the 50%. There's a program that helps you do this, but you work out where the best spot to keep it. So even like it just helps with you. If you need to escape, you've got to have that extra percentage to help escape. So thrusters one, shield generator has to go on two, shield cell banks are on two. I might consider changing that. I don't know yet. Burst lasers are on one, shield boosters are on two, the burst lasers again, and the power plant and chef launcher and cannon are all on one, plus fuel scoop should go on to five. That's better. Hatch is on five, frameshift drive is on one, life support is four, so that's my early warning system. I'm going to try this method out. Sensors are on one, standard docking computer 5, heat sink launcher and chef launcher and power plant, they're all one. Fire grips are simple, three burst lasers tied together, two cannons tied together, and a separate fire grip for the discouragement. I wish you could have three fire grips in one thing, that would make it much better. Cargo space is going to be 128. I know I'm limiting myself to the cargo space hold. But now this is where we're going to go. I'm going to go hunt down four pirates. And we're at the present moment at Founder's World. That's where we want to go to. I hope I can actually find four pirates here, because last time I went to there, I just absolutely garbage. There was nothing. Okay. Now the reason why I went for the A4 shield cell banks is because I wanted something. Let's see how loud this is. I wanted something that gives me a bit more, less weight into the ship, but the same amount of protection. I was looking at putting a B5 into there. Oh, sorry, B5 instead of an A5, right? Which would only give me, which will give me exactly the same I'm getting at the moment with A4s, which is 160. And I was thinking, oh, do I do that or do I? I'm looking at my shields. I want, when I want to do it, I want to be able to get my shields back up to full strength as fast as I can. Now, as I said before, look at this. When you look up, no wires. You don't see anything out of place. It looks nice. It looks tidy. Now, this is fair enough. I'd like to say this is a one seater. Could you put yourself in the center? But look at this. It looks tidy, and it's a fraction of the cost of an Anaconda. So I hope we can find some farm pirates here to kill and test out our weapons. It's only small pirates, I'll just use the lasers against them and so forth. Now, we won't even bother refueling. No, I was going to do it anyway. While we're doing that, let's have a look. Okay, let's head off in a general direction. Oh, what's that? That's there we are. Now, you'll find pirates in these signal sources. Now, you can find the strong ones if you really want to take on a bit tougher pirates. Weak signal sources, I wouldn't recommend. They're more items like your black boxes and so forth like that. And some, if you've got an interdictor, you can interdict ones, or you can be interdicted yourself by pirates. Hoping there's going to be at least one, maybe two pirates in here. Let's get this ship organized. Would I like to? That's better. We may need more. Let's go more power to that. One on each. That's good enough. Let's jump in and say hello to them. And Nutter. That's just bloody typical. Absolutely nothing. Oh, there's something here. What are you? Anaconda. Oh. Second force remote. What are you, sir? Are you wanted? You are wanted. Now, this is a lot harder without a triple monitor on. Okay, Mr. Anaconda. Wasn't expecting to take you on. But your shields are down. Points left. Beautiful. That's one down. Let's see how much that can charge my shields back. Set back to full. Wow, that bloke didn't want to let up. It's the first time I found one of those things floating around in here. So that's one of the pirates we had to kill. So what I'm going to have to do is we're going to go to the nearest space station, reload. If we've come across another unidentified signal source, we'll drop in there and have a look. But I had to use a lot of shield cells for that one. So I don't think I want to play with another anaconda just yet. So what do we got as in... I've still got... What do we got? I've got one left. Well, it depends. I'll give it a crack. I'll have a look if there's something along the way. We'll drop in and say hello. What did he have to say for himself anyway? Oh, I've got to do this one. No. Let's go into that one. Let's just have it. I've got one pirate down, I've got three to go. I hope they're not all anacondas. That would kind of be not good for my health. But I don't normally get that close to an anaconda with this type of ship. I prefer to fire from a distance so I can get that turn and keep the anaconda basically in front of me at all times. That is a secret when I like to fight anacondas and stuff like that. See, I'm surprised actually that was actually in there. How many of those weapons did I fire anyway? Still got plenty of cannon. I only used up 10 cannon shots, I think. It's also a good test to seeing how the shields are. Okay, what do we got? Let's go have a look at you first, sir. You're wanted. We'll just go throw it into reverse. Dead. Next. One's close, you are him. I think you are, sir. Let me get this. Line you up. You're wanted. I could just find it. What's her name, Annie? Don't want to waste the shot, though. Nope. Don't go running away. Dead. This one's the last one left. And he'll probably be clean. Yep. So, now that is... Four, we need to kill one more. Two, one, engage. Hope it's not another anaconda then. I could be in trouble. First of all, let's line ourselves up to the port we're going back to. We'll collect the bounties. We'll collect their bounties here as well. And then we'll just hand that in and collect that when we go. When we get back to Founder's World. fair hike to the station, I tell you. That's the closest one. That's the closest one. Oh well, we'll get there. Probably have. If I kill the next Bambi before I get there, I'll probably stop the video and then I'll quickly start. Oh, there we go. I'll just cut it out as we're going along. Cause really, you don't really need to see all this, do you? Looks nice though. Especially in the triple monitor, it looks absolutely beautiful how it lights up and stuff like that. So we need to find one more unidentified signal source, or hopefully the Bambi tries to pull me out of hyperspace. Or tries to interdict me. Which would be nice. I still can't wait to the day we can get to actually walk around our spaceships. That would be awesome. Ah, there it is. Try this one. There should be one in here. He might have some friends in here as well. Ah, oh, don't tell me that person's left it, has he? What's that? Who are you? Ah, damn it. Okay, we won't bother going to that one then. And then try this one here instead. Ah, it's going too fast. I always do that. See, sometimes you go into one of those, you line yourselves up for an unidentified signal source, and if you see anything come out of it, there's no point going into that one. You might as well just go to another one, because you'll find nothing is in there. Sometimes you'll see bad people jump out, but most of the time you're going to see like system foragers jump out, and then if you do jump in there, the cop is either system or foragers or absolutely nothing. Not nitter. Always got to be patient and go into here. Now the reason why I call this one an all-purpose Python is because I can do pretty much everything with it. I can take this into war zones, I can hunt down pirates, I can land on anything, basically. I've got 128 ton of cargo, so I can make a little bit of money here and there. And now what do we got here? Nothing. What do we got? Target that. Ah, oh, great, a Type 9, I'm not even going to bother scanning him. Every time I come across a Type 9 in here, they're nothing. You know what I mean? They're absolutely nada. But anyway. And I can do missions for the Empire or / Federation. And they're pretty much a standalone ship. Now you can make this a pure Warcraft ship. Like explorer or just even trade if you wanted to. Best one of course to trading, I think it would be the Anaconda. But I've just chosen to make mine an all purpose one because it's got the scanners on. Oops, what have we got here? No, that's a strong one. Let's go, don't go there. We'll line it back up to the station and we'll go from there. I decided, well, I want an all-purpose one. I can scan things if I come in. Oh, what's this? No, the same thing. I can scan stations. I can use it so when I'm, if I'm going from, say, Founders World to somewhere else and I haven't been there before, I can basically, if I've got the time, I can just explore that area, and from that we can then just go, oh yeah, we've got the area explored. I could probably dock in computer, put another thing onto there, but instead of, I forgot the time, I can then explore the area and go forth. Now I'm thinking of putting an A5 shield generator. Now I'll have a look at the stats of it before. I might put an A4 and an A5 in there, so a combination of both firing at the same time. Even then, did you notice it did overheat my systems with the weapons firing at the same time, so I've got to figure out how I can cool that down without using certain things. Too fast again. It's a fine line. Way too fast. The thing is, I want to try to get a bit more maneuverability into this. Right? And because this thing does not like to... Like when you're flying at normal and you're flying around a station, it feels really great, but in battle against some of the lighter and smaller ships, it feels like you're flying a, like how do you describe it? It's like a tank versus a sort of, you know. So I really want to try to get other things done. Now, come on, let's see if we can find this last one we've got to kill in here. I don't want to spend 4 hours trying to find something to kill. I want to get in there, kill what I have to kill, get my dividends done, and then get out, then get back to where I've got to drop off and get to make the money. Now, here we are. We should have one of these. Oh, you're clean. Damn. You're clean, are you? You're clean, and you'll be clean too. Bugger! Scan detected. How rude. They're all clean. Ah.
Scan detected.
What the? Sorry, mistaken identity. I thought you were someone else. Oh well, let's get out of here. I keep doing that. Let's go back to the go to the station, and we eventually find him. I hope. This is kind of highly annoying because I've killed 3 out of 4. Hopefully I can find this last one before we get to the station. It would be good. I don't want to go in there, then reload, then have to come back. Oh, another unidentified signal source. Please, let just you be the bad person we're after. I have to admit, when I'm flying the... when I'm using the Imperial Courier, you look, and you've got that, you've just got so much you can look at when you're flying it. You know, I don't like the too much enclosed ones. This one's a bit better. It's got a bit more openness, I think, than the, say, the Anaconda, and it looks better, the interior. There's no loose wires or anything like that there, right, floating around the thing. So let's go find our way into here. Hopefully the bad person's here and we can kill him. I guess before I'm recording this for Fraps, the video has been set to 1920x1080. I've got this on one monitor and I've got it stuck at 30 frames per second through Fraps, and it's split every 4 gigabytes. And I'm using Audacity to use for the voice thing. And my... yeah. Oh, cool. Now I hope I hope that's the one I got. Please be wanted. I want to play with yes you are. Hello, sir. Oh, that's okay. Don't have to turn around. No. No. Please don't tickle me. Try that. Did that hit him or not? Let's go forward. Better use him. Let's see if I can hit him with one of these big cannon. He's dead. That's pretty. We finished it. Yay! Let that recharge the shield, and we'll go to the space station where we were going to. Oh, we're talking. Yeah, we'll go this one.
Frameship drive charging.
You want speed, those shields will charge up. And then we'll go to Founder's World and collect our bounty. So pretty much now, this is a nice setup. Like lasers I'm going to be using primarily on medium to small ships. And the big cannons together, I'm going to be using those on medium to large ships. Small ships, if I can get a good shot on, I'll try to take them out that way, but I'm going to try to hold off the arm, especially if I'm in a combat zone, like a war zone. I'm going to try to hold the shot off. Yeah, I'm going to withhold the firing. If I can take like an eagle out just with my laser, I'm not going to waste the ammo, even if I might have a perfect shot with it if I'm in a conflict zone. So I want to sort of reserve the ammo for the bigger ships or medium to big ships. Oh, we're not going too fast in here. Uh-oh. Slow it down. Come on. That's better. Now we're going to try to land into a letterbox. And what I'm going to do here, if we can, is try to line this up with the planet at our backs and the space dock at our front. All we're going to do is just basically refuel, don't need to worry about too much, reload, rearmor, fix up anything we need to fix up. And then we sell and also get the contracts for those. If I go up here, try going this way, travel past a little bit, but we're trying to get into the right position if we can, and I'll try to go forward a bit, and then bring this around so it's sort of the plane's even, I hope. Not the best way, but we'll give it a crack. Now, this way, if I'm jumping into the sun, it's automatically a decreased throttle, but since I'm jumping into a station, I want to have full throttle going into there. Basically, everything onto systems and 200 engines to help control everything. And sometimes it takes forever. Oh, I can't look at that. Oh, that would have been nice. There they are. I see the sun. Ah, we're here. Almost. We had to go down probably a tad further. So, let's get all this set up. We have to go. Where is the entrance? the other side, let's say. Let's boost down to... There it is. Oh, I can't see it now. Let's bring it into focus again. There we are. Try to adjust your ship so when you're coming in. It's going to be a nice smooth thing. Request the...
Docking request granted.
Now, I'm not going to slow down too much because what I'm trying to do is... line it up so when I come in, I'm going to just keep coming straight in. Arr. Don't get in my way, sir. Do I get the lights on or not? Let's see if it's... Oops, not the wrong button. That's where the lights are on. And what I'll do here is I'll just simply go, come in, brakes on. And the auto docking will take care of everything else. Oh, there's that one. So now that cost me 3,580 to reload. And 47 in fuel. We go to contacts. Come on. We made 244,196. And then we'll go back to here. Just want to check the repair. That's fine. And select our destination, and then we'll be back out of here. Now, eventually, I'm trying to get to Admiral in Federation and King in Empire. So, this helps towards my Federation rank. And also adds a kill, because I think I've got to get at least like 200 odd kills or something like that in the Federation. So basically what I'm going to be doing for now is I'll think about having a look at the Empire or Federation, which one I reckon I want to do too, because I'm Count and I'm Post Commander. So I'm in two minds of which way I want to do that. I really would have been nice, this one nice, sitting in the middle of the sea. Or, and having said the another person in the back, or back slightly to the right behind you, something like that. But in other words, this is beautiful. I haven't been using the voice attack too much. Sometimes I use it, sometimes I don't. If I don't need to use it, I use it, I use it, but if I'm chatting away like this... Okay. And won't be long before we back into Founder's World again. I think this would be like how to kill pirates with style or in comfort. So I probably will have a look at that. We'll go there now and have a look at the shield, and we'll probably put, if I put one on shield, if I put that four onto an A5, right, instead of having an A4, see? Fuel scooping now with an A5 fuel scoop makes life a lot easier. Now, I'm thinking if when we get back we'll put this onto an A5 shield cell, so we'll have one A5 shield cell booster and one A4 shield cell booster. That is per shot gives 160 for the A4, and A5 will give 185, so that's 345 we can then potentially put back into our shields. Now I think half wolves, let's go have this curiously. Got to goodness, have a look since we're going to go past that. We might as well have a quick look in. He's going to jump out of it, damn it. And let's have a look who jumps out of it. That's system defense. Yep, so pointless going into that one now since he's just jumped out of there. So I think the shields are 565 or 556, I think they are, and you divide that by 3 and that will give you approximately half your it gives you approximately half your shield value. Now I'm not 100% certain on that. I mean, other players have been teaching me the best uses, like telling how to work out shield cells, strengths, and so forth like that, and what to use, how to divide it and so forth, so you can work out what you have and so forth when you want to like use your shield. You want to be able to do it just under half, just on as you're scratching the second ring, and when you activate them you want to what's the name? Yeah, it's Founder's World. Beautiful place, isn't it? And then you want to sort of like when you activate him, you want to basically give yourself full shield. Oh no, no. Give yourself full shield protection back, even if they're still firing at your shields. So by the time the delay of them activating, the delay and then firing at you, you really want to still be able to get your full shields back when it finishes. So then you can pop a flare or something like that, at the same time you can pop a flare as your shields are trying to come back if they're using gimbaled weapons, and that will help distract their gimbaled weapons. I like this one, it's beautifully red. Let's have a look. Far enough went up, still gotta get further away. Right. So we can line ourselves up with the letterbox. I like to try to line myself up with the letterbox most of the time, but sometimes it's easy just coming in, going around the space station as you're targeting, and then you just basically, when you get close enough, just request the docking and then just go in that way. Now, get the right position, how I want it. That will do. And sometimes when I'm talking to people, I keep forgetting to do that. So here we go again. Keep it nice. And you can do this with any ship. It works with any ship. And you just line her up and put your brakes on. See how easy that was? Best way of using a docking computer route.
Docking successful. Engines disengaged.
And now, let's first of all have a quick look at it. We'll get our contracts first. No, sorry, wrong one. Got to go into. Okay, 10 credits we use for fueling. I just got a habit of fueling up every single time, so when I leave, I always have 100% fuel. Regardless of when we're going between one or two stations, I still like to have that 100% fuel. Now, we'll clear this one, we'll finish this one, and see how much that gives. So, we've got that. Now, that's asking to deliver cargo. These people we don't want to work for because they're not Federation. only federation on this one we want to work for. There's a delivery mission we can do. There's a contained fortune and learning in the past. That's probably a, oh, what's this one? They're stolen ancient thing. And symphitic meat. Oh, they want me to transport it, do they? Yeah. I might do that. I don't know yet. And no, that's a charity one, but if it was a charity federation, I would automatically pay for it. Looking for light cargo. I might try that one. Don't know yet, but we'll see how we go. Now, before we head off, now here's a quick look at, quickly change this, and then, so those cannons work well. They don't give you much shots, and let's change that shield cell bank from an A4 to an A5. Even though this will get, I can go up here and we'll do it this way. I wish this automatically does like the name ascending. Now that would make life a lot easier. If you had that automatically in the settings, so when you go into there, it saves it, so you know exactly what you're looking for then. It's just annoying when you have to change it all the time. Like, same as when you have to change it from economy, or was it economy route, or trade routes to the fastest route. Now they've done that in there, but they should do that in here, because it just makes life a lot easier here. So when you come in, you can know exactly what you're looking for. Now see, this is what I have at the moment, two A4s. Now an A5 will give me basically the same amount of things. Now, but I'm increasing the tonnage by 10. I am increasing the power drain by 380. So, or 0.380. My lead and jump drive will go down, massive increase, and yeah. But I'm still under my 30 power watt available, so I will select that. Now, we'll have a quick look at what ships there are in this, in the shipyard here, and the prices, since we're here. Okay, we're going to start with the Sidewinder. Sidewinder is 28,080 credits. Then we've got the Imperial Eagle, 29,312 credits. Not Imperial Eagle, sorry, Eagle. Oh. Hola, which is 46,262 credits. Adder, 77,054 credits. The Imperial Eagle now, at 97,254 credits. The Viper at 125,422 credits. The Cobra Mark III at 333,205 credits. Diamondback Scout at 495,200 credits. Type 6 Transporter at 917,822 credits. Diamondback Explorer at 1,662,652 credits. The Imperial Courier, and now I love this little ship. I've got one decked out for exploring slash killing people, and one decked out just for killing people. I actually might put the Explorer kit on the other one as well, because I've got had four shield banks into there, right? So four shield cell banks in there, and honestly, I can take this into a high conflict zone, and sometimes not even use the first two shield cell banks tied together. So this price is at 2,231,422 credits. I love this little ship, and the view you get in it when you're flying, oh, it's fantastic. Now, then we've got the Vulture, which is, I'm not much of a fan of the Vulture. That's 4,322,232 credits. This little ship is designed to hunt down this ship. Asp at 5,845,160 credits. I do like the Asp. It's another all-rounder. The Federal Dropship, I hate these things with vengeance. If I get a chance to, and they're on the other side, I purposely look for them with my little Imperial Courier and take them out. 12,560,720 credits. Long as the thing doesn't hit me, I can take it out. The Type 7 Transport, which is 15,331,900 credits. Or 31,900. The Federal Assault Ship. I hate this thing too, and I purposely hunt those things out when I'm looking to eliminate things in that. That's 17,386,970 credits. Imperial Clipper. Now, I do love this ship. I will buy another one of these and deck it out for a war situation. I'll have a look at what I can play around with it. That's at 19,564,818 credits. It is a nice ship. Federal Gunship, which is another ship I hunt down and purposely destroy with my little Imperial Courier, at 31,426,970 credits. The Orca, which, oh my god, this thing is ugly. Alright. It's something, if I've ever seen the battlefield, I will hunt down and destroy, even if I only have an Imperial, like a Sidewinder. This one is at 42,593,754 credits. And this one here, I can't really pronounce it, Feed the Lance. I can't pronounce this one too well. Other people use these, and they use them very effective, and they're good at hunting down anacondas. Like one bloke I was having a chat to, he took on, I think it was a wing of two anacondas with this thing, and won. So that's impressive. This one is a 45,250,078 credits. Python, now this was at 49,998,353 credits. Now, if you look at the Python compared to the one I had set up, the stock standard Python is a lot, the speed wise is down, boost speed is down, FPS range laden is down, unladen is down, the shields are way down, and the armor is down. So you really need to spend the money. When you're going to buy something like this, you really want to have enough money behind you to buy buy another one. If not, basically you want double the money, really, I think. You want to be able, because you're going to use a lot of that to put into here. You're going to spend a lot of money on this thing, and you want to buy at least two or three rebuy costs, which I'll quickly show you that in a second, how much mine cost. Then you got the Type 9 Heavy, 67,177,750 credits. They're okay. And then of course, at the moment, the cream of the crop, the Anaconda at 128,965,693 credits. Now, this is worth it, to be getting elite. If you just, like, if you're playing this game, and even just try to explore, if you're close to or in combat, instead of doing anything else, put all your effort just to get that elite status, right? Because that, as you can see, the bonuses that it give you there. Now, like this, I currently only have 95 million at the moment. The rebuy of this cost is 12,771,917 credits. We've gone through the modules and quick look at my stats so far. Current assets is 1,033,413,815 credits. As you can see here, this is what I've done, how many times I've killed. Insurance claims, I've only had 21. How many people I've killed, claims, and so forth like that. Trading. But I highly recommend getting your elite status first, so you can use this at your home base, alright, and then build up from elsewhere. Anyway, my name is Commander Black Dragon, signing off. Thank you for watching my videos, and all comments are welcome. You all have a great day now.